early morning, Turks and Caicos, on the beach. Really nobody's here. So peaceful. Good way to start the day. Definitely a good way to start. So, just doing some grounding. So wonderful to put your feet directly into either sand, the grass, beautiful ions.
I'm not going to eat all of this bacon, but I do love some bacon, so you're going to have some of this with me. Damn, the plate is hot.
She warned you. She warned you.
I know, she warned you. And I did a cheddar mushroom egg white omelet. You're going to have my potatoes.
Yes.
I do love potatoes, though, but I can't stop when I have... I'll go on like a frenzy. And the coffee is really good. I don't know where they get their coffee. I judge places by bread, by their bread and their coffee. And the coffee is very nice. Show
Chef
the
Peter's
people.
Egg and muffin.
Chef Peter.
Chef Peter.
Like my dad, who never cooks. He can't cook like minute rice. Oh, my dad.
Dad. He does steak.
But like he doesn't cook. He can't cook. He can grill, but. Like he cannot cook. He's not a chef. Like chef, this is what Chef Peter says. Show them. Sorry to paw your food.
Pawing it. Got the classic bread, bacon, sausage, cheddar,
More potatoes.
Adrienne's toast.
Yeah, I gave my toast away. Yeah.
Super excited.
Temperature's still good. I'm not trying to be dramatic, but like we could not have wished for better weather with this.
Exactly.
Yeah. So later on, we are going to do some horseback riding. This will be my second experience ever on a horse. You used to take horseback riding. Well, yeah, but I had a really docile horse. So I don't know the temperament of the horse that they're going to pair me with. And I know horses, animals in general, but horses can pick up your energy. So I'm just going to try to be really chill. So hopefully it doesn't please don't toss me, into the water. The last time we had a really great experience, the only thing, the last time we rode the horses, I don't know if you remember, we were like in the middle of the ocean. I never knew horses eat seaweed, like as they're going through the water, and they were eating the seaweed and I was kind of like in the back and they were pooping in the water and like it was like drifting by. I'm like tucking my leg in. I'm like, oh. My horse was like the very slow, nice horse. So I'm just seeing all of these nuggets like floating in the water at me. I'm like,
all right, let's see.
Yeah. Always goes back to poop. Anyway, so we're gonna do that. This is gonna be a different company this time, but we're gonna try and document it. I'm gonna kind of leave that up to you because you're steadier on a horse. You have more experience. What did you use to ride? Western? English?
English.
So he'll be vlogging more of that. Don't drop my phone in the water. We do have carrying cases for the phone. So, we're gonna eat our breakfast and head downtown, see the sights, and do it with full belly.
Yes.
I'm so excited. I think this is jasmine. I'm not certain, but the smell coming off of them smells like jasmine to me. One of my favorite flowers, one of my favorite aromas. I wish these did better in Connecticut. I would grow them everywhere. We're looking for gifts for the girls. We found some really lovely candles and some teas and things we're gonna bring back with us. It's a beautiful like herbal apothecary here. We have all sorts of really lovely things, and there's some sage and Palo Santo, just gorgeous shot. His sunglasses. He loves the Arabians. Let's see. Fire. Yep.
You know, they say that
fire.
You know, you turn into your parents, and I certainly am.
Oh, is that what your dad?
Every time my dad and I would go
dad glasses
on a vacation, we'd have to buy or at least look at some sunglasses. So here we are.
Are you gonna wear your sunglasses at night?
Oh yes.
I love that. I actually picked out this pair for him, so everybody knows.
Yes, this is Adrienne's selection.
Yeah. You put your shirt on like two. And you're like, I like these best.
Yep. Know what I want?
They're dark and steely, and all of the rums. Love Bambara rum and the rum cakes. So I'm gonna bring back some Bambara rum and maybe the mini rum cakes. They're tinier. Yeah, these little guys are the perfect size. Different flavors, different types of rum. But they are known, this is their brand in the Turks. Bambara at Beans and Leaves. It's a really cute coffee shop. So they have bubble tea here. That's what caught my eye. So I think we're going to get a bubble tea. I haven't had one of those in a long time. And some really nice snacks, pastries. Getting back to the beach. And it's another very sunny and gorgeous day. And like, if this isn't the most common photo that people take with the knees and the ocean. But what a day, guys. So warm. I was just in the water. Very comfortable. It was spritzing a little bit in the past. That's a great thing about the island, is that these little bits of rain go pretty quickly. And they weren't recently affected too badly by that hurricane that blew through, thank God. So just watching the waves and the sailboats. Sailing out in the distance there. Humidity's pretty low.
Maya! Come on, Winsley!
Bumping the John Mayer tonight. Coco Bistro is surrounded by all of these palm trees, like a whole canopy of them all around you. Makes it such a unique spot on the island. How's the menu looking here?
Drink menu is looking good.
We'll show you what we got.
What are we doing?
The music has now changed to Bob Marley, which is really, I like this vibe more. I not that I don't like John Mayer, I do like John Mayer, but this feels more tropical.
Right.
Love Bob Marley. So we just put in our order, starting with conch, two waves. And I ordered a Paloma. You ordered what?
A Black and Mahi.
And yes. Your drink was the Dark and Stormy. Oh, here it is. Here's my Paloma. So here we have the conch two ways. Pierce, have you had a lot of conch in your life?
I've experienced quite a bit of conch.
How do you like your conch?
I'll have my conch anyway. I could have conch three times a day if it was available.
So this looks like breaded right here with some kind of a yummy glaze and some mango and looks like scallions. And then this is the ceviche side, which I'm really excited for. That's how I personally like my conch, like this, in a ceviche raw. And
noted.
This is the, how do you like your conch?
How do I like it? Really, anyway. There's not many ways I don't like conch.
Are you gonna have, put, honking them out.
Yeah. There we go. Oh, it's gonna be a good bite.
How is that con? Fresh, I hope.
Oh, that is some of the freshest con.
Does it taste good?
It's fantastic.
Try the hot con. Get a big one.
It's the only way to have it.
Mm. Yeah.
That's, go with that
is
one.
That, is that good? It's good.
Yeah, it's great conch. Great conch.
So Turks and Caicos is actually known for their conch. It's all over the island. This is where they harvest it. Like they're all over the beach. And it's actually really delicious. We once did a snorkeling excursion, got one straight out of the ocean, and had it as a ceviche like that. So we're going to dive into this. But this is our appetizer. So our food is here. Pierce got the blackened mahi-mahi with some broccoli and like some jasmine rice. It smells really good. I got the salmon. Looks like there's some blackberries, rice. Crisp kale, again, smells incredible. Cannot wait to try this. Are you excited?
So excited.
And the conch chewies was also pretty amazing.
I like my conch like I like my mahi-mahi. Blackened.
Oh my god. You're just making all types of like noises. Is it really good?
It is.
Are you having an experience?
This is an experience.
Delicious. Good flavor.
Can't even describe it.
Mine is also like sapid. Amazing. Delicious. I can't stop eating this. But he was just making a lot of sounds, so I wanted to ask what was going on. This is Pierce. Did you like it?
Just scarfed it down like an animal.
Wow.
It was great.
Did you eat the garnish? Did you eat the
parsley? I'm a little disappointed in myself that I didn't give it the Genuss.
Genuss in Swiss means like savoring your meal. I think, you know, you didn't.
It deserves more.
It deserves
more.
Genuss. Yeah. I think really you savored it up as best as you could.
As best as I could. You know, instincts kick in.
I'm leaving some of mine behind so that I can nibble on it tomorrow, maybe around lunch. It's so good. It's like a shame to eat it all in one sitting. It's a pretty good portion, but it's delicious. How's your dark and stormy?
Tasty.
So we have a beautiful rum cake here, and they wrote happy anniversary because our 11 year anniversary just went by. This looks so soft and amazing. Look at how gooey. You ready for this?
Oh yeah.
Dig in. Okay, we're trying to catch a sunrise or at least some beautiful colors in the sky. If you hear that spraying in the background, it's Pierce hitting himself with some deep. Every morning here, I've been getting up at like either 5 or 6 in the morning. I could sleep in, but I just choose not to, I guess. Let's see if we see any beautiful colors. And this is supposedly a good spot. So we're here. The sun should be coming up somewhere over here. It's very beautiful and quiet here. Totally different part of the beach. This is a great way to kick it off. And a very nice, again, secluded area of the island to visit. Breakfast time in the room. We went to the Grace Bay IGA. And what we have here are some eggs, blueberries, bacon, avocado, and I've topped it with some goat cheese.
Excellent job.
Thank you. It's just all done in a microwave, so there's like no stovetop in our room.
And we were able to do this. We have our coffee maker. So it's really easy here at the Realist Indies to bring in your own food and be able to eat in your room or out on the patio like we're doing this morning. So we're going to dig in and get our energy for the day. Can't survive without the coffee. I have been waking up literally, at 5 or 6 in the morning every day we've been here. I could sleep in like a normal person would on vacation, but I'm just so excited to be here that I want to get every second out of the day. I think that's what it is. The room has been very comfortable. Have you enjoyed like the room, the bed, everything?
It's been fantastic.
Yeah, we're on ground level. No weird noises, no weird smells, just very really cool. Good, you know, housekeeping. We enjoyed the pool and hot tub last night after we got back from dinner. Tonight, we're gonna go to Parallel 23, which is another one of our favorite restaurants at the Regent Palms. So we're excited to return there. Last night's dinner at Coco Bistro was phenom, like so good. And this morning, yeah, we saw the sunrise, so it's been really good. And then today, what kind of day do you think we're gonna have? Just really chill
day,
beach day,
beach,
literally
pool.
Just lay out and enjoy the art of doing nothing.
Yes.
Everybody always needs to be busy all the time, and there's something to be said for just being still and really letting your body melt and unwind and listening to the ocean. And I think that's what today is going to be all about. And he got a little bit overexposed in the sun yesterday, even though he reapplied, even though he was really diligent with his sunscreen. He's fair, so we're probably not going to snorkel this time. We were maybe going to snorkel, but given that he's gotten a little bit pink, we don't want to play with that. But it'll turn to a tan. Your Italian side will take over and you'll turn to a tan. But there's really no healthy tan, guys. I've seen so much melanoma as an esthetician in clients that have either done the sunbeds or, you know, laid out when they were younger, and you've got to put on that sunscreen and continually reapply because the rays here are no joke. So we're gonna dig into this breakfast, and then maybe we'll really go ham on dinner.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So here we are at the Sands. We stayed here in 2012, I want to say, and we discovered Hemingway's here on site, and I felt like we had this conch salad every single day. Really delicious and of course fresh right here off of the island. So we're going to revisit that and see if it's as good as it was back then.
So you see, guys, conch the way you like it. There's 4 different ways you can have it. The way I love is the salad raw conch, marinated in sour orange juice and jalapeno sauce. It's actually low carb, very refreshing, very just like cool and lovely. So I think that's the way we will be getting it today. Starting off with their rum punch, which looks really good. And my basic B, vodka soda. I can't do too many of the sugary drinks. I had a drink last night that was a little bit more sugary. So this will be good for me. And vodka soda has a nice little kick to it, as we all know. Here is our conch salad inside of a conch shell. It's a pretty big portion, so we're gonna share it. Some people could probably easily eat this all on their own, but I feel like it's a lot. So really packed with protein. There's onions, pepper, carrot, orange juice, jalapeno in here, so it has like a little kick. I think it's a beautiful way that they present it. So we're going to enjoy this, and just wanted to share it with you. If you're in Turks and Caicos, check out Hemingway's, check out their conch salad ceviche. But you can have it different ways if you don't like raw, but this is probably the freshest you can get it, especially on this island. Again, this is what they are known for.
So excited.
going back to the beach, surprise, surprise. But yet another beautiful day here. So why not take advantage? We're gonna veg out. He brought his snorkel gear, so he's gonna snorkel a little bit. Me, I'm gonna just like be sunning myself like a turtle.
Those seagulls are, you know, northeast you get these really like rabid seagulls that they see like a horn ship and they go out of their mind. So this is very, very serene. Go take a little dip, cool off. All right, guys, at the Regent Palms, parallel 23. I find this to be one of the most beautiful spots to dine. The architecture here is just really, really nice, very elegant. Beautiful. So we're gonna get in.
Here at the Regent Palms, we've eaten here before on the island and we had to return. Here's how does the menu look?
Looking good.
Yeah, we're gonna get drinks first and it is gorgeous here. Their menu is really, really good. I'm just looking at some of their drinks right now. So we'll show you what we end up getting. Our anniversary went by, so we're starting off with champagne. They brought it over as a little treat for us. So I'm not a big champagne drinker, but I'm gonna do it. So I got what's called the Queen's Martini. It has mint, cucumber, and green apple in it. Typically a dirty martini girl, but this is something a little different. I was very intrigued by the cucumber and the mint. Pierce has a
rum old fashioned.
Rum old fashioned. Really yes. Like a rum kick.
Yeah. Rum well, punch. When you're here, you have to.
You do have to have the rum.
One rum.
Rums.
Rums.
It's just one rum here. It's the Bambara.
There's Bambara, there's another one.
I did see another one.
But I think the Bambara is local.
Bambara is their thing. Okay, well, let's go for it. Here we're just starting with a lovely tuna tartare. I don't know, it just looks so wonderful with radishes and cucumber. Nice little garnish. Thoughts on the tuna tartare? Thoughts?
It's giving the conch a run for its money.
I think it's really good too.
It's really good.
Here's not to have a little do-over with this drink, but this first drink, I mean, they look the same, but we both tasted it and you're both like,
yeah.
And it was the wrong liquor in there? What did she put in there? Negroni or something?
I think they used just way too much bitters.
Bitters, yeah. There's a lot of bitters in the first one. So we never complain really, but we just, you know, we asked her this way.
Be polite and hope for the best.
Exactly. So this second one is just
much better.
Right.
Much better.
And my Queen's Martini. You have to try it. It's so good. Cucumber, the mint, it goes down real easy. So this could be dangerous, so I'm just going really slow with it. But I'm glad you got it. I'm glad they helped you out.
I'm happy though.
All right, does anybody else have to look at other people and like try to figure out their life? Like this lady's trying to read the menu with her phone. I know I'll get there one day. I know I'll be that person with my eyes. Do you do that with people? Do you try to like read the people?
I don't really care enough.
I like to just scan around and like read the body language and the looks.
That is entertaining, yes. Especially when you can sense that tension.
No, these two look happy. She might be a little annoyed. She looks irritated. Like she looks like she just wants to get the frick out of here. And this lady's still examining the menu. Yeah.
So here is my grouper. It's a local fish found here on the island, just encrusted with different kinds of pistachios, scallions, there's radishes. It smells incredible. Caicos. I cannot wait to try this. It's one of their specials tonight. And Pierce, what did you get?
We got the short ribs. Looks like there's some noodles.
Ooh, that smells good too.
Noodles. Sesame's. Mm-hmm. Oh, and look, a cat.
A kitty cat. Hi, Mama. Hi, oh, the kitty cat's always friendly. Hi, baby. Do you want to know how to cut calories from your meal? How to cut calories and fat from your meal easily on the island? Just have a begging animal all dinner long, rubbing up against you, begging and looking pathetic and wanting food. It's very nice. I wish I could take you home. I do. So I shared my grouper with this little one. You shared nothing. You're very greedy with your short ribs. She would have liked that.
Officially back from dinner, our last dinner on the island, at least for this trip at Parallel 23 at the Palms. What did you think of dinner?
It was great.
So let's start from the beginning of our trip. Our flight was a very interesting flight we'll see how tomorrow is. We were accosted by some interesting aromas and interesting sounds. Do you want to discuss that? Well, where do we begin? The first thing I think that happened was, I don't know, maybe 30 minutes into the flight. Well, first we were seated next to a guy who decided to use his cologne as like his method of just cleanliness. Like he bathed in his cologne. So that was a little tough. And it wasn't a particularly like nice smelling cologne. It was really, really pungent.
Strong, musky.
Really pungent. Yeah. But you were next to him, so you were kind of like the human shield. That
I, Spencer for in the ceiling.
That I could kind of tolerate. But then, maybe about 30 minutes into the flight, I don't know if you've ever been to like the Beardsley Zoo or any kind of zoo, or gone like up to the monkey cage like that in like the hot summer, but it just all of a sudden smelled like a monkey cage in high heat. I'm like, what is that smell? And I'm like looking at you, and I'm tasting it. So there was a bad smell. There was a baby in front of us. But as a mom, you know, I've smelled a lot of baby poop, and that smell was not from a baby. That was not an infant. That was an adult scent. I don't know where it was coming from. You were getting it. I'm like, please point the air vent at me, the little air vents that are in the ceiling. I was like, please blow it in my direction, because you can't escape. And then I decided I'm gonna watch a movie, and I had my earbuds in, but there was a girl behind me, and I don't know if she just didn't have earbuds or what was happening, but she was like just taking her phone and like holding it and bumping all sorts of genres of music, and it was really loud and super annoying. And I don't know if she was anxious because she like opened and closed and opened and closed, open, closed, open, closed, opened, closed her window shade on her plane window. She was near the window, like literally 30 times. So maybe she was really anxious. I don't know what was happening, but it was loud. So between that, a lot of like sounds and interesting smells emanating in a very, very tight quarters. But we got to our destination. The flight was very easy. There were no delays. Maybe we boarded like 10 minutes later than we normally would have, but not too bad. I'm hoping the flight home will be super easy. The guy who drove us in, our limo driver, was amazing. If you guys need a name of a limo driver in Fairfield County, Connecticut, I can give you guys a name. He was wonderful, so friendly, so nice, and pretty reasonable.
Yeah. Better than an Uber.
Better than an Uber, for sure. So tomorrow we're gonna have breakfast in the room, maybe head down to the beach and just pack up our things and go. But as far as our trip, we had some amazing food.
We did. Great food.
Top experience for me was riding the horses again. Yeah. that to me is just the most magical, amazing thing. I was like choking up, crying while we were like riding through the ocean. It's just, you can't top it. It's so, so surreal. I recommend anybody who comes to the island, even if you have no riding experience, get on a horse.
It's easy.
Go into the ocean. You will not fall off. It'll be fine. It's a beautiful experience. What else? I mean, just laying on the beach, just being in that water is so healing. And this was not our longest trip, by the way, to Turks. We've done longer trips here, but let me tell you, even just a few days in this environment, like, I feel changed. How about you? What was like your top experience?
Oh, I mean, being in the water, for me, I love the water, you know, but here it's just so relaxing.
Apparently when he was a baby, his mother told me that like he was thrown into the water. He did like one of those water baby courses at like 6 months. I'm like, you threw him in the water? But he was like one of like the model baby swimmers. He did water babies, so he was one of those children that was like swimming
at 6 months.
At 6 months,
model
old.
Baby swimmer.
Good job. Put it on your resume. Like, no, I'm kidding. So yeah, he's a really good swimmer. I don't like to go that deep. I get a little anxious. I like to kind of stay to the surface of the water. But you did a little bit of snorkeling. You saw some fish.
Yeah.
We got some shells, we got lots of souvenirs, and the food. What was your favorite food place?
Tonight was pretty good.
Parallel 23 was pretty amazing. It's such a beautiful, it's a stunning environment. There was that cute little cat that kept visiting that I wanted to like shove in my purse, not shove it in, you know what I mean? I wanted to take that kitten. Mm-hmm. Coco Bistro was amazing. Indigo was amazing. I can't choose.
It's tough. It's tough.
All the food places we had gone to were wonderful, wonderful food. I really liked Indigo. We got to meet the chef. He was so nice.
He was very nice.
It's the
service at Indigo, I think, was
the best.
The best.
Yeah.
But the food at Parallel 23 was, I think.
Except for your drink.
Well,
except for his first drink. Something happened with his first drink. Something wasn't right.
They made that right.
But the follow-up one was perfect. So we're not going to wait so long to come back next time. Next time we hope to bring back our kids and let them experience the magic that is Turks and Caicos. If you guys ever have any questions about the island, again, I'm not a pro about the entire island. I'm pretty familiar with Provo, which is the main island. We haven't been to the other little islands that are part of Turks and Caicos, but that will be something in the future we'd like to look at. But our flight leaves tomorrow at 2 o'clock, and then we should be back in Connecticut by I'm guessing like around
6, I think.
No, we're getting back to JFK around 6.
Oh yeah, you're right.
So be back to the girls by bedtime. I miss them and I can't wait to see them. It's weird. It's weird not being with your kids, but we messaged and FaceTimed with them every day, so that helped. And I hope this becomes a place that they'll love as much as we do. So I hope you guys enjoyed seeing little snippets of our quick little trip here, and we'll be back.
We definitely will.
We'll be back.
Yes.
See you later.
Bye.
Bye.